welcome to the history class. Today we will be studying another important and interesting chapter, the Rashtrakutas, that is chapter number 4.8. Students, please note down the important points, and also I will discuss the questions and answers related to this chapter. Karnataka was ruled by number of important dynasties such as the Kadambas, Gangas, Chalukyas of Badami, Rashtrakutas, Chalukyas of Kalyana, Hoysalas, Vijayanagara and the Odeyars of Mysore. One among these important dynasties was the Rashtrakutas. The Rashtrakutas had established a very vast empire in South India, and they ruled for a long period of time from 753 to 978 CE. The Rashtrakutas started their rule as the subordinates or the feudatories of the Chalukyas of Badami. Later they became their political successors. The Rashtrakutas contributed much for the cultural development. The word Rashtrakuta is derived from the two words known as Rashtra and Kuta. Rashtra refers to the country and Kuta refers to the officer. Therefore, Rashtrakuta denotes power. Inscriptions mentions the name of Rashtrakutas as Lattaloro Puravaradishwara. This shows the Rashtrakutas originally belongs to Lattur or Lattalore in Maharashtra. The royal emblem of the Rashtrakuta dynasty was Garuda, and their capital was Manyaketa or Malake, which is situated in the Gulbarga district of Karnataka. The founder of the Rashtrakuta dynasty was Dantidurga. He was the first king, and he started his rule as a subordinate of the Chalukyas of Badami. Later, he revolted and declared his independence and laid foundation for the Rashtrakuta kingdom. Dantidurga was succeeded by Krishna I. Krishna I completely defeated the power of the last Chalukyan king known as Kirtivarman II, and he strengthened the position of his empire. The rule of Krishna I is very important in the history of Rashtrakuta Empire because of his cultural contribution. The most important contribution made by him was the construction of the monolithic stone temple at Ellora, known as the Kailasanatha Temple, and this temple known for its artistic excellence. And this temple was constructed by him in the year 770 CE. According to one of the most important historian known as Dr. V.A. Smith, he called this temple as one of the greatest artistic works of the world. Krishna I was succeeded by Govinda II. But Govinda II ruled only for a short period of time because he was a very weak and inefficient ruler. Therefore, Govinda II was defeated and dethroned by his brother known as Dhruva, and Dhruva made as the king of the Rashtrakutas. Dhruva was considered as one of the most prominent among the early rulers of the Rashtrakutas, and he made the Rashtrakuta power as an all-India power by his North Indian and the South Indian conquest. The political condition of Northern India was very favorable to Dhruva. At that period, the three major kingdoms and rulers ruled at that period are Vatsaraja, the king of Pratiharas, then Pala kingdom was ruled by Dharmapala, then kingdom of Kanauj was under the control of Indrayuda. The Pratihara king known as Vatsaraja and the Pala king of Bengal known as Dharmapala, they had an eye on the kingdom of Kanauj and to establish their supremacy over Northern India. Taking advantage of the confused political situation arose in Northern India, Dhruva with his army marched towards Northern India, and he completely defeated the three major kingdoms such as Pratiharas, Palas of Bengal and the Kingdom of Kanauj, and the rulers also accepted his sovereignty. Because of this great success, the Rashtrakuta Empire reached up to the Ganga-Yamuna basin. Later, Dhruva gave more importance for the expansion of his empire towards South India. At first, he defeated the Vengi Chalukyan king known as Vishnuvardhana IV, but he maintained friendly relationship with them through the matrimonial alliances. He married the Vengi Chalukyan princess known as Sheela Bhattarike. Dhruva defeated the Ganga king known as Shivamara II. Shivamara II was imprisoned by him. Later, for the administration of Gangavadi, Dhruva appointed his eldest son known as Stamba as the head of Gangavadi. Later, Dhruva defeated the Pallava king known as Nandivarman II. Because of the various conquests made by Dhruva, the expansion of the Rashtrakuta Empire all over India, to show his greatness, he got the important titles known as Dharavarsha, Sri Vallabha, Narendra Sena and Kali Vallabha. After the death of Dhruva, his son known as Govinda III succeeded to the throne, and this Govinda III faced the revolt of his brother known as Stamba, who was appointed as the governor of Gangavadi by Dhruva. And Stamba got the help of the Gangas and the Pallavas. Govinda III completely suppressed the revolt made by his brother Stamba, and he also defeated the Pallavas and the Gangas who gave their support to Stamba. Like Dhruva, Govinda III also gave more importance for the expansion of his empire towards northern India. At that period, the Pratihara kingdom was ruled by Nagabhata, Pala king was known as Dharmapala, and the kingdom of Kanauj was ruled by Chakrayudha. And these three powerful rulers, they quarreled among themselves in order to get the political supremacy over North India. Taking advantage of the position, Govinda III marched with his army to northern India, and by defeating these three major kingdoms, he established his supremacy over northern India. After his victory, Govinda III marched towards the Himalayas, and it is said that the horses of the army of Govinda III drank the water flowing in the foothills of Himalayas, and the elephants bathed in the Ganges. In South India also, Govinda III expanded his empire. He completely defeated the powerful kingdoms of South India. The important South Indian kingdoms defeated by Govinda III are Gangas, Pandyas, Keralas and the Pallavas. Even the king of Ceylon surrendered to Govinda III. Therefore, because of the various conquests made by Govinda III, the expansion of the Rashtrakuta Empire all over India. Therefore, his empire reached up to Himalayas in the north, to Kanyakumari in the south, and in the west, his empire reached up to Saurashtra, and in the east, his empire reached up to Bengal. This shows the greatness of Govinda III. The important titles got by Govinda III are Jagatunga, Prabhuta Varsha, Sri Vallabha and Tribhuvana Dhavala. After the death of Govinda III, his son known as Amogha Varsha succeeded to the throne in the year 814 CE. When Amogha Varsha became the king, he was a very young boy. Therefore, Karka became his guardian. Amogha Varsha was the most greatest king of the Rashtrakuta Empire because he inherited a very vast Rashtrakuta Empire from his grandfather known as Dhruva and from his father Govinda III, and he protected this vast empire by following the policy of peace, because Amogha Varsha was a peace-loving king. He ruled for a long period of time, nearly 64 long years, and his rule was considered as the most glorious period in the history of Rashtrakutas. Amoghavarsha was a good administrator. He was an able warrior. He was a wise statesman, religious tolerant ruler, patron of literature and learning, and patron of art and architecture. The power and prestige of the Rashtrakuta Empire reached its highest level under Amoghavarsha. The rule of Amoghavarsha is also known for number of conquests. At first, Amoghavarsha defeated the power of the Vengi Chalukyan king known as Gunaga Vijayaditya in the year 830 CE in the famous Battle of Lingavalli. The able general of Amoghavarsha was known as Bankesha, and Bankesha had got control over the northern part of Ganga kingdom or Gangavadi. At that period, the Ganga king Rachamalla, who tried to reconquer the lost territories, but in his efforts he was not able to get success. Later, with the death of Rachamalla, when Niti Marga Ereganga succeeded to the throne, he declared war against Amoghavarsha. The famous battle fought between them, known as the Battle of Rajaramudi, in the year 856 CE, and in this war, Amoghavarsha was defeated. Amoghavarsha maintained friendly relationship with the major kingdoms of South India at that period because he was a wise statesman. Amoghavarsha gave his daughter, known as Chandralambe, in marriage to the Ganga prince known as Bhutunga. Sheela Mahadevi was given in marriage to the Vengi Chalukyan prince known as Vishnuvardhana, who was the son of Vijayaditya II. Then another daughter known as Shanka was given in marriage to the Pallava king known as Nandivarman III. This shows Amoghavarsha was a wise statesman, and he maintained friendly relationship with the major kingdoms of that period. According to the Nilakunda and Shiruru inscriptions, Amoghavarsha was respected by the rulers of Anga, Vanga, Magadha, Malwa, Vengi and neighboring kingdoms. At the last days of the rule of Amoghavarsha, he had to face the revolt of Prince Krishna, who was the Yuvaraja at that period. But the revolt made by Krishna was suppressed by his able general known as Bankesha. Therefore, in memory of Bankesha, Amoghavarsha built a new city known as Bankapura, and Bankesha was appointed as the governor of Banavasi. Amoghavarsha was a religious tolerant ruler, though he was the staunch follower of Hinduism, and he was the devotee of goddess Mahalakshmi of Kollapur. He showed religious respect to the other two important religions known as Jainism and Buddhism. These two religions received royal patronage. The period of the rule of Amoghavarsha was considered as the period of the development of literature and learning because Amoghavarsha himself was a great scholar. He patronized number of other important scholars in his court. They are Jinasenacharya, Mahaviracharya, Shaktyayana and Sri Vijaya. The guru of Amoghavarsha was known as Jinasenacharya, who was the author of the most important works known as Adi Purana and Parshvabhidayam. The most important mathematician known as Mahaviracharya, who was the author of Ganita Sara Sangraha, a work on mathematics. Shaktyayana, the important grammarian, who was the author of Shabdanu Shasana. The most important Kannada poet who lived during the period of Amoghavarsha was known as Sri Vijaya. Sri Vijaya was the author of the first literary work in Kannada known as Kaviraja Marga. Kaviraja Marga also mentions the extent of ancient Karnataka as the land lying between the two rivers known as Godavari River in the north to Kaveri River in the south. Amoghavarsha was the patron of art and architecture. During his period, he beautified and rebuilt the city of Manyakheta. Because of this, Manyakheta became one of the most beautiful and finest city. The rule of Amoghavarsha is very important because Arab traveler known as Suleiman visited his period, and in his accounts, Suleiman describes the achievements and greatness of Amoghavarsha. Suleiman, the Arab traveler, says that the Rashtrakuta Empire was one among the four greatest empires of the world, and he compared the Rashtrakuta Empire to the other important empires of the world such as China, Baghdad and Constantinople. Then Amoghavarsha, who gave more importance for the welfare of his subjects, according to Sanjan plates, Amoghavarsha sacrificed one of his fingers to goddess Mahalakshmi of Kolhapur in order to save his empire from the severe famine. The titles got by Amoghavarsha are Atishaya Dhavala, Veera Narayana, Nripatunga, Sri Vallabha and Ratta Martanda. Totally we can say that the most greatest king of the Rashtrakuta Empire was Amoghavarsha. The period of the rule of Amoghavarsha saw the most glorious period, and that was the period of peace and prosperity, the period of cultural development. The power and prestige of the Rashtrakuta Empire reached its highest level or zenith under his rule. Then about the successors of Amoghavarsha. Amoghavarsha was succeeded by Krishna II, Indra III, Amoghavarsha IV, Govinda IV, Amoghavarsha III, Krishna III, and the last king was known as Karka II. During the rule of Karka II, he was defeated and dethroned by Tailappa II. Later, this made the end of the Rashtrakuta Empire under Karka II and the foundation of another major empire in South India known as the Chalukyas of Kalyana under the leadership of Tailappa II. Next, we pass on to the another part of this chapter, the contributions of the Rashtrakutas, and this is very important for the examination point of view also. The question will be asked for 10 marks. The Rashtrakutas contributed much for the cultural development in the field of religion, literature and learning, and in the field of art and architecture. The Rashtrakutas are the followers of Hinduism or Vedic religion, but they showed religious tolerance towards the other religions such as Jainism and Buddhism. The greatest king of the Rashtrakutas was known as Amoghavarsha, who was the devotee of goddess Mahalakshmi of Kolhapur. In the field of literature and learning, the development was made during this period because the Rashtrakuta rulers themselves are great scholars, and they patronized number of other poets and scholars in their court. The most important Kannada and Sanskrit literary works are written during this period. First, we take up the development of Kannada literature. The most important Kannada poet known as Sri Vijaya was the author of Kaviraja Marga, and this Kaviraja Marga considered as the first literary work in Kannada, and also this work mentions the extent of ancient Karnataka as the land lying between the two rivers known as Godavari River in the north to Kaveri River in the south. Ponna was the another important Kannada poet. The title got by him was known as Ubhaya Kavi Chakravarti. He was patronized by the Rashtrakuta king known as Krishna III. The important Kannada works written by Ponna are Shanti Purana and Bhuvanaikya Ramabhidaya. Pampa was the most important Kannada poet, lived during this period. Pampa, popularly known as Adi Kavi of Kannada, and he was patronized by Arikesari II, the feudatory of the Rashtrakutas at Vemulavada. Pampa was the author of the two important Kannada works known as Adi Purana and Vikramarjuna Vijaya or Pampa Bharata. Another important work was Vaddaragane, the first prose work in old Kannada language, which was written by Shiva Kotyacharya. The development was made in the field of Sanskrit literature and learning. The greatest king, Amoghavarsha, was the author of Prashnottara Ratnamala. The important poets patronized by him are Jinasenacharya, Mahaviracharya and Shaktyayana. Jinasenacharya was the author of Adi Purana and Parshvabhidayam. Mahaviracharya wrote Ganita Sara Sangraha. Shaktyayana was the author of Shabdanu Shasana. Trivikrama was the another important Sanskrit scholar who was the author of Madalasa Champu. Asaga wrote Vardhamana Charite and Halayuda was the author of the two important works known as Kavi Rahasya and Mrita Sanjeevini. Totally, we can say that much development was made in the field of literature and learning. In the field of art and architecture also, the Rashtrakutas contributed much. Their architectural contribution was wonderful. Number of structural temples, cave temples and basadis are constructed during their period. The important architectural centers are Ajanta, Ellora and Elephanta. Ellora as one of the most important architectural center of the Rashtrakutas. Ellora is situated in the Aurangabad district of Maharashtra. 34 beautiful cave temples of the Rashtrakutas are found here. The most important among these temples was the Kailasanatha temple. Kailasanatha temple at Ellora was built by the Rashtrakuta king known as Krishna I in their 770 CE, and this temple is the monolithic stone temple. This temple measures for about 164 feet long, 109 feet high and 92 feet wide. And this temple was considered as the most artistic work of that period. The temple is also having Mahadwaras, Quadrangle, Shikara and Linga, which are constructed in the Dravidian style. In front of the temple, Nandi Mantapa. Two beautifully carved pillars and two huge statues of the elephants found near the temple. This temple also known for the important sculptures. The most important among them was the sculpture of Shiva Leela attracts the attention of the tourists, and there are five temples around the Garbhagraha related to the subordinate deities. The other important sculptures found here are Ashtadikpalakas, Ganga, Yamuna and Saraswati, which are carved very beautifully. Ravana lifting the Kailasa mountain, hence this temple known as Kailasanatha. The other important cave temples found at Ellora are Ravana's cave, Dashavatara, Rameshwara, Neelakanta, Indra Sabha and Jagannatha Sabha. Another important architectural center of the Rashtrakutas was Elephanta, and this Elephanta is an island 6 miles away from Mumbai. Total 7 beautiful cave temples of the Rashtrakutas are found here. The ancient name of Elephanta was Goravapuri. Later this was renamed as Elephanta by the Portuguese. The most important cave temple found at Elephanta was the Trimurti temple, and this temple related to the three incarnations of God, such as creation, protection and destruction. The important sculptures found here are Dwarapalakas, Ardhanarishwara and Shiva Parvati. In the field of painting also, the Rashtrakutas contributed much. The cave temples of Ellora depicts the important paintings belongs to their period. Totally, we can say that the Rashtrakutas contributed much for the cultural development in the field of religion, literature and learning, and in the field of art and architecture. Finally, we come to the end of this chapter, and now I will briefly summarize the main points of this chapter. Please note down the points also. One of the most greatest dynasty of Karnataka was known as the Rashtrakutas. Rashtrakutas are the political successors of the Chalukyas of Badami. Their capital was Manyakheta or Malakade, situated in the Gulbarga district of Karnataka. Their royal emblem was Garuda. The founder of the Rashtrakuta Empire was Danti Durga. Krishna first known for the monolithic temple at Ellora, known as Kailasanatha Temple. Dhruva, who was the most prominent among the early Rashtrakutas. Then Govinda III was the another important ruler. They made the Rashtrakuta power as an all-India power by their number of North Indian and the South Indian conquests. The most greatest king of the Rashtrakutas was Amoghavarsha. The period of the rule of Amoghavarsha was considered as the most brightest and glorious period. That was the period of the cultural development. The Arab traveler visited the court of Amoghavarsha was known as Suleiman. Cultural contributions of the Rashtrakutas. The Rashtrakuta rulers are the religious tolerant rulers. The two important religions received royal patronage are Jainism and Buddhism. And also, in the field of literature and learning, the Rashtrakutas contributed much. The development of Kannada literature. Sri Vijaya was the author of the first Kannada work known as Kaviraja Marga, which mentions the extent of ancient Karnataka. Ponna, known as Ubhaya Kavi Chakravarti, patronized by Krishna III. The important works are Shanti Purana and Bhuvanaikya Ramabhidaya. Pampa, popularly known as Adi Kavi of Kannada, patronized by Arikesari II, the feudatory of the Rashtrakutas at Vemulavada. The important works written by Pampa are Adi Purana and Vikramarjuna Vijaya or Pampa Bharata. The development of Sanskrit literature during the Rashtrakutas. We have to give importance to the important Sanskrit poets such as Jinasenacharya, Mahaviracharya, Shaktyayana, Trivikrama, Asaga, and also Halayuda. Amoghavarsha was the author of Prashnotara Ratnamala. The development of art and architecture during the Rashtrakutas, their contribution was wonderful. The important architectural centers are Ellora and Elephanta. Ellora, famous for the Kailasanatha temple built by Krishna first. The number of cave temples located here. Another important architectural center known as Elephanta, ancient name was Goravapuri, renamed as Elephanta by the Portuguese. Among the seven cave temples at Elephanta, the most important was the Trimurti temple. Then in the field of painting also, the Rashtrakutas contributed much. Now we will discuss the questions and answers of this chapter. There are 10 one-mark questions. You have to answer these questions in one word or in one sentence. The royal emblem of the Rashtrakutas was Garuda. The capital of the Rashtrakutas was Manyakheta. The founder of the Rashtrakutas was Danti Durga. The greatest king of the Rashtrakutas was Amoghavarsha. Arab traveler visited the court of Amoghavarsha was Suleiman. Ponna got the title Ubhaya Kavi Chakravarti. Ponna was patronized by Krishna III. Pampa, known as Adi Kavi, Pampa was patronized by Arikesari II, the feudatory of the Rashtrakutas. Students, please note down these important questions. Then we pass on to the next part about the 2 marks questions. You have to answer these questions in 2 words or in 2 sentences each. The Kailasanatha temple at Ellora was built by Krishna I. The titles of Dhruva are Dharavarsha, Sri Vallabha, Narendra Sena and Kali Vallabha. Titles of Govinda III, they are Jagatunga, Prabhutavarsha, Sri Vallabha and Tribhuvana Dhavala. Titles of Amoghavarsha, Atishaya Dhavala, Veera Narayana, Nripatunga, Sri Vallabha and Ratta Martanda. Students, please give importance to these 2 marks questions also. Then for 5 marks, there are 2 questions about the achievements of Govinda III and the achievements of Amoghavarsha. The 10-mark question about the cultural contributions of the Rashtrakutas. Here we have to write their religious life, the development of literature and learning, and the development of art and architecture. Thank you, students.